Today on BRStv, we're going to show you how to test for chloramines. Hi, I'm Ryan, your host of BRStv. Today we're going to show you how to test for chloramines in your city's water. Chloramines are now used in an estimated 25 to 30% of U.S. households, even higher in densely populated areas where most households are on a municipal water supply. Taking a quick look at a map like this one, you can see areas like Texas, Florida, Louisiana, and Kansas are already over 50% usage. Places like California, Pennsylvania, Indiana, Minnesota, Kentucky, Maine, Missouri, New England, the Dakotas, the Carolinas, Oklahoma, and Virginia are all using chloramines as a disinfectant for a large portion of their population. This is a number that's only going to grow because chloramine use makes it easier for cities to meet some of the tough new standards the EPA has implemented for municipal water supplies. There are three ways to find out if your city is using chlorine or chloramines. First and easy is just to call your city water supply and ask. Easiest way to find the correct number is to check your water bill or call your city hall. Second is use a simple and cheap total and free chlorine test strip like this one. Total chlorine reads a total volume of chlorine, which includes free chlorine as well as chlorine that might be bound to something else like ammonia, which would be chloramines. The free chlorine test only reads chlorine. Give the stick a quick dip, shake off the excess water, and read. If both free and total chlorine read the same amount, it means your city's using chlorine. If the total chlorine reads at higher ranges, like between 2 and 4, but the free chlorine reads close to 0, that means most of the chlorine is bound to something else, which is typically ammonia, and your city is using chloramines. You can also use a standard test kit rather than a test strip, which most people will find a bit more reliable. And for those of you that want the most accurate readings, the Hanna checkers are a nice option. The checkers are capable of reading all the way down to 0.01 parts per million. The last way is just test your carbon blocks for total chlorine as they get exhausted. Standard carbon blocks don't work well on chloramines, and many will only last a few hundred gallons before they see significant chloramine breakthrough. Considering wastewater, that means you'll likely have to change the carbon blocks after just a handful of water changes, which is ridiculous. There are some carbon blocks out there specifically designed to treat for chloramines. They cost 1.5 to 2 times as much, but they can treat chloramines for 4 to 6 times as long as a standard block, which makes them a much better overall value. If you already know what your city uses, tell us in the community in the comments area down below. You may just help some of your neighbors have a healthier, more successful reef tank. If this is your first time with us, hit that subscribe button because we release new videos like this every week. See you next Tuesday with another BRStv how-to.